Have you ever seen the subscribe button animation on YouTube that triggers exactly at the time when the presenter asks you to subscribe to their channel? In this video, I'll show you how to recreate an interaction like that and trigger an animation exactly at the right time based on the video content. It's really cool and really simple. Here's how it works. Before we dig into the code, I want to mention that this effect is not really identical to that of a YouTube. I don't really know what exactly YouTube does to create an interaction like this, but this solution right here is the simplest one that I found that you can use to create an interaction where at a certain point in a video, based on the video content, a certain element like call to action button lights up. You will find the link to the demo in the description, and the video is equipped with timestamps so you can jump ahead to any part of the video that interests you. If you don't want to hear about the setup, just go directly into the coding part. This solution will work in all modern browsers, and everything you need for it to work is the video tag along with the video and a subtitle track that accompanies that particular video. In this demo, I have a video tag here and source with my video content and the subtitle track that is right here. This is a standard subtitle track that I've generated. I will open it quickly here so you can see. Nothing special about it. Format is WebTT and it comes with timestamps and the text that accompanies every time frame. Speaking about subtitles for the video, there is a very simple way you can generate your own subtitles automatically for free. You can use YouTube to do that. You can upload the video that you need subtitles for to YouTube, and YouTube will automatically generate subtitles for that particular video, and you can download those subtitles in any format you want, including VTT, which we are using right here. You don't have to publish the video to get the subtitles. As soon as you upload the video, even if it's in the private mode, you will get the subtitles and you can easily download them and then tweak them. It's not an ideal solution, but it works pretty well. For this example, I've used Teachable to generate subtitles for this video because I'm using Teachable platform for my course Mastering LinkedIn. If you want to check it out, link is going to be in the description. And of course, if you do check it out, you will directly support this channel and CSS Weekly. Thank you so much. If you do, use the coupon code VIDEOQ to get additional 20% discount on already discounted pre-launch price. In any case, for this effect, you will need a video element and a subtitle track accompanying subtitle track, and the subtitle track will need to be active for this interaction to happen, for this effect to work, and you can pretty much guarantee that it will be shown if you set the default parameter to the track that you want to show by default. I have it set here on my English version of the subtitles. I don't have different language, but you can have multiple tracks here if you want. What we want to do here is we want to find an active cue when the video is playing, and then in that cue, in the text of that cue, search for a specific keyword like subscribe in our example, and then we can of course trigger an animation or effect that we want. For this demo, we will trigger this beautiful animation on this button, subscribe to CSS Weekly, and this is actually a button that was created by J.H. Tompkins. You're going to find J.H.'s links in the description and in the demo itself as well. Follow him on CodePen, on Twitter, wherever you can find him. He created a ton of amazing, mind-blowing demos exactly like this one. You should be definitely following him. So this is the effect that we want to trigger at the right time in the video. And we will find the right time by looking for active cues in the video itself. Let's jump into JavaScript. First, we will find all our track elements, document query selector all. We'll search for track, and we will save this into a constant tracks. Now we want to loop over all of those tracks that we found. We will use for off loop. We will set here constant track of tracks. The track element has a number of event listeners, and the one that we want to use now is cuechange. Cuechange happens every time the subtitles change on the screen. So at the time when a certain cue is shown on the screen, we want to dig into that cue, find its active text, and then we will work from there. We will add event listener to track, track.addEventListener. Event listener is going to be cuechange, and we will just use anonymous function here with the parameter event. When the cue is changed, we want to actually get an active cue, and there could be more active cues, so we will loop over all of them. I'll save them into constant cues. We're going to find them in event.targeted.track.activeCues. If you want to see quickly what we have here, you can use console log cues. I will open my Chrome console here. Let's clear this and let's play the video. I will mute it before I do, and subtitles are enabled as you see right here. And as soon as the cue changes, which is when the first subtitle becomes invisible, I will get my active queues, which is this text track queue list object. We will loop over this object, and then for each queue, we will find text, and we will look for a specific string in this text. Let's close the console here, Command Shift I. I will again use for off loop for const queue of queues. I will save the text of this queue into constant txt, queue.txt, and we will actually immediately convert it to lowercase because it will be easier to work with it this way. And now, if this text contains a specific keyword, subscribe in our example, we want to trigger an animation. So if txt, we will use includes method, and we will just use string subscribe. Actually, subscribe should be enough because we want to trigger this effect every time the keyword subscribe or any of its equivalents like subscribing is mentioned. Let's just do console log here for starters, and let's just say subscribe. I'll open the console again, clear this, and mute the video and play the video. And now, as the queues are changing, immediately when the subscribe keyword is mentioned, we should get something in our console, and indeed we do. Here is the word subscribe. When I'm asking you to subscribe to CSS Weekly YouTube channel, you should do that if you haven't already. And here in the console, we do have exactly the output that we want. So this is exactly the point in the video that we want to target. All we will do now is we will find this button, and this button, I will inspect it, has a class button. So we will search for the button, and to trigger the animation, this particular button has specific class animate that triggers the animation that you've seen. We'll close the console, and I will look for my button right here at the top of the file, and we'll change tracks to button, and I will not use query selector all, but rather just query selector, because I do know that in this example, I have only one button on the page. And now, instead of this console log, I will actually add a class animate to my button. I will use class list object for this, and the method add, and I will add class animate because I have a CSS set up in a way that when the class animate is present on this particular button, then it will be animated exactly the same way as you see on hover, this effect right here. Let's try it out. Indeed, exactly at the moment when this subtitle is shown that contains the word subscribe, the button lights up. So all we need to do now is we need to remove this class animate when we no longer need it. And for that, I will simply use the cuechange event. So I will copy exactly the line I have here under my queues constant. I will switch button.classList.add to button.classList.remove. This way, on every queue change, we will remove the class animate. And then if that particular active queue contains the keyword subscribe, then we will add class animate, which will essentially animate this button. Let's try it out.
Hi, my name is Zoran Jambor. I'm the author of CSS Weekly. And right now I want to ask you to subscribe the CSS Weekly YouTube channel. That's a pretty cool effect, right? Well, on the channel, you will, as you've seen, immediately when the subtitle changes, this class animate is removed and button is no longer lighting up. And this is essentially everything you need to create an animation. Like you see on YouTube, you need a video with a track element. And in that track element, you will look for a specific keyword. Once you find it as an active queue, then you just do the interaction that you want to do as you would do anyway. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Jambor. I will see and hear you in a different subscribe interaction, or rather in the next video. And until then, don't forget to subscribe to CSS Weekly YouTube channel. I am talking about it constantly during the course of this video and even in the demo. If you still haven't, please do. I'll appreciate it greatly. And of course, on the channel, you will find more amazing tutorials like this one. Thanks so much. Bye.